His Excellency Mr. Paul Kagame, President of Rwanda, Mr. Holin Zhao, Secretary General of the International Telecommunication Union, Dr. Carlos, the representative of the co-chair of Broadband Commission, Mr. Kevin Martin and Nick Clegg, representative of Facebook, Your Excellencies and Commissioners. It's a great pleasure to speak on behalf of UNESCO at the spring session of the Broadband Commission for Sustainable Development. As you may know, I'm here at your invitation on behalf of the Director General, Madame Azoulay, co-vice chair of the Broadband Commission, who is engaged in week-long commemorations of one of UNESCO flagship program, World Press Freedom Day, which will be organized in Addis Ababa this year. I will be joining Director General immediately following today's session of the Broadband Commission, and this year's theme is dedicated to media for democracy and addresses journalism and elections in time of disinformation. Here in Menlo Park, we have had an excellent opportunity to address disinformation through a multi-stakeholder foundation, which is the norm and strength of the Broadband Commission itself. I was very pleased to co-share with the Commission, the Commissioner Hessa Jaber, constructive discussions on the Working Group on Freedom of Expression and Tackling Disinformation. I believe there is a consensus that disinformation negatively impacts people's right to access to information and fundamental freedoms, essential to promote peace, justice, and resilient and rule of law-based institutions. And therefore, disinformation works against the achievement of Goal 16 of the United Nations Sustainable Development Agenda. As we approach the Broadband Commission's 10th anniversary, I'm as well aware as you are that this commission was founded on a shared vision to try to establish a uniquely global public-private partnership and intellectual alliance for policymakers, academic through leaders and broadband entrepreneurs who contribute at the forefront of digital innovation policy and who have committed themselves to the service of development aligned to the sustainable development goals. Within the United Nations system, it may be argued that no other commission in existence has a greater potential to tangibly support governments and citizens in achieving the 2030 agenda and each of its 17 sustainable development goals. As we move into a second decade, next spring, we must continue to seek new ways to fulfill our potential and create optimal synergies for tangible services to the SDGs. One interesting specificity of the Broadband Commission is that the broadband space covers all surrounding technologies platform from all internet-linked devices, the Internet of Things, to the role of artificial intelligence, neural networks in the analytics of big data, and a human-centered and human rights-based development agenda more broadly. Broadband-based frontier technologies, including artificial intelligence, inspire hope for a much better chance to achieve the SDG 2030 agenda, but also have inspired constructive reflection on the potential risks and challenges of human rights. Are there risks that extractive artificial intelligence technologies may impact human rights or further widen the global digital divide between the information rich and the poor? UNESCO's approach to addressing broadband, internet governance, and AI aims to be holistic and inclusive of all stakeholders, enlarging the discussion of include ethical dimensions of AI, including in education, scientific practices, cultural diversity, ethics, and human rights. UNESCO's member states have adopted the Internet Universality Principles captured in the heuristic we call the Rome Principles, namely rights-based, open, accessible, and multi-stakeholder. Implicit in this multi-stakeholder approach is that neither government, nor the private sector, nor international organization, nor civil society, nor technology companies, nor any single stakeholder should determine accountability over the internet space in an unilateral way. Over the past 25 years, UNESCO has had an intergovernmental mandate to foster ethical reflection on emerging technologies through its normative contributions on biotics, the ethical implication of climate change, and the ethics of science and technology generally. Following a decision just this month of UNESCO's executive board, the 14th session of the UNESCO General Conference, comprised of 193 member states, will convene this October and examine whether to elaborate a new standard setting instrument on the ethics of artificial intelligence in the form of a non-binding recommendation. Alongside many of your organizations, UNESCO shall work to promote advocacy, awareness, and foresight on the emerging technologies surrounding broadband. UNESCO will support member states in addressing opportunities and challenges brought about by the rapid nonlinear development of broadband within UNESCO's field of competence, namely education, sciences, culture, and communication. Before concluding my statement, I would like also to thank Facebook for her host and the wonderful organization of this event. And thank you very much for your attention.